Okay. Show me.
Hi there guys, welcome back to the Dutch RC channel for a first video in a series of videos. What I have here in this big and heavy box is a 3D printer, and I am a complete novice. This is my first 3D printer. I have never worked with 3D printers. I have seen them, I've seen other people use them, and I've wanted one for decades, no, years, quite a long time. So I am very happy to have this box here. I'm super excited, really. Obviously I don't know if it will actually work out well. We'll see. And again, this is the first video of a series. In this series, I'll take you on a journey into 3D printing land, into the 3D printing universe, whatever you want. If you are interested in 3D printers, maybe you are considering one, this series should give you a good impression of what it's like, what the hurdles are, and if it works out well, basically. So in this box there should be a Creality CR10. I got this one from Banggood. There is a link down in the description to it. And what I should first tell you is why I ordered this specific printer. First thing, it has a pretty big printing volume. 30 centimeters by 30 centimeters by 40 centimeters. Which is, there are bigger printers, but it's pretty big. And I want to be able to, for instance, print airplane parts. Maybe not entire airplanes, but at least wings, for instance. Will that work out well? I don't really care. I want to be able to experiment with that. I also want to be able to print smaller parts. But again, I want the opportunity at least to be able to print bigger things. So, besides that, this Creality CR10 is basically a no-brainer if you calculate the print volume against the price of this printer. It's not the cheapest printer, but the cheapest printers. I've done a lot of research on printers. This printer is very popular, and I think that's for a reason, several reasons. One of them being that print volume. The second one is that it actually prints pretty well. No, it's not the best printer, but then again, you can spend thousands of dollars on a printer, and surely those printers will probably do better. This one should be at least decent, and it's upgradable at low cost, maybe in some cases at close to zero, wow. Very low cost, you can upgrade them. Okay, first part, in this part we'll take everything out of the box and have a close look. This is obviously not a review. I'm not in a position to review a 3D printer as I have no experience with 3D printers. Again, this series is more to illustrate what the journey into using a 3D printer is like. If it can be at least relatively successful without too much of a hassle. Okay, it's a sturdy box, straps. Let's get into this box. I'm anxious to see what the parts look like. Okay, here we go. We get out a knife. Be careful when playing with knives. Get yourself a good and sharp blade. I hope actually I'm opening the top rather than the bottom of the box. Alrighty, things are covered by a foam plate, which we throw aside like so, because I can. Okay, actually let me position the camera a little higher for you. We see printer goodness. Cool. I'm so excited about this this unboxing. Okay, there's a bit of plastic helping to keep things in place here. Damn, I need my knife again. There. The first thing in the box, in the top level, is our printer bed, so to speak. The horizontal part of our printer. There. With print bed, heated print bed, if you are not familiar with this printer or any printers at all. There are printers with and without a heated bed. And yeah, if you are opt for a printer that does not have a heated bed, this plate over here, you are severely limiting yourself in printing material options. You'll print PLA, PET materials maybe, ABS, probably not. And so yeah, that's part of the reason why I got this printer. It has a heated bed. Okay, it has some quite a lot of plastic covering. And one of the things I really want to know is if this glass plate, it has a glass plate covering the heated bed, is actually level. So let me get a ruler. There. Oh, that looks pretty good. The reason why I'm checking this is because I have obviously done my research, which is the first thing you need to do if you are considering a printer. And what I found was that some people receive this printer with a warped print plate, the glass plate, so it's not dead level. This one, yeah, I do still have the plastic on it, so it's not an end-all be-all test I'm doing here, but it looks pretty all right actually. Huh, cool. I'm happy about that, of course. So we'll set this the base of our printer with extruded aluminium aside for a minute. We'll take a closer look at all the components when we have gotten rid of the box. There's nothing more to see on this layer. We've got foam. We set this aside like so, because I can. Okay. We find a roll of what looks like painters, a masking tape, but this is probably to put on the glass plate, and I probably won't be using this. Again, I've done my research, maybe you want to use it, it's nice that they include it, but I probably won't be using it. Maybe I'll use it as masking tape for paint jobs. So I'm happy with this. We've got a cardboard box within the box. Ooh, it's heavier than I had expected. Let's see what is in this here box. Okay, we've got instructions, installing instructions. So this sheet, oh, it's only one sheet. Some Chinese things, lead screw fixing. Okay, manuals, important of course. Very nice that they include some manuals. There are also a lot of videos about the Sprinter online, but nice. Okay, we've got a spool of printing material. What is it? It is PLA, 1.75 millimeters in white. Now, I don't know if it's good stuff, this. I've got quite a few other rolls that are probably better, but yeah, it's nice that they include it to get you started. We've got our power cable, which is nice because we want power. Power is good. And this one has a European style connector. There's another one with a, what is this? What the hell is this? What kind of connector is this? Huh? It doesn't look like an American plug. No, not at all. What is this? Okay. Okay, but well, the cable ends in a, well, a connector that's used in PCs. So a cable like this is very easy to come by for your country. Okay, we got, what is this? Nozzle? No. Okay, assembly, hardware, screws and such. We've got a nicely braided USB cable. Huh, mini USB by the way. Cool stuff, nice cable. Huh, okay. We've got a printer spool holder. Mandatory. And we've got ourselves a scraper to scrape the thing you've printed off of the bed. Very nice. This is to bracket to hold that spool holder in place. I'm not sure how, but well. Okay, hardware to assemble the printer, or parts of the printer, basically. Oh, nice. Unexpected. Pliers. Cutter pliers. And a bunch of zip ties. I had not expected tools like this to come with a printer. Again, it's not a an expensive printer at all. Tools. Okay, lots of other tools as well. Wrenches. Allen keys, screwdriver, nice. In my mind, they didn't need to add this at the price of this printer. Okay, and a USB card reader with a memory card, probably a small one. Oh, 8 gigabytes, huh. Okay, more than expected, very nice. Okay, that's about it, a filament routing tube, bogen tube. Okay, that's it for this box. Next thing in the box is, whoa, this is bigger than expected, hot damn, and also heavier than expected. Okay, this here box, it's far bigger than I had expected. Huh. Okay, this is the brain of the operation. This box controls and powers your printer. It has an LCD screen over here, a control knob. Clickety click. Yeah, clickety click. Okay. And I'm not sure what this barcode is for an app maybe? I'm not sure. Okay. Okay, this knob of course is to navigate through the menu, and over here
We've got a selector to select between 220 volt and 110 volt. Very nice. An SD card slot. SD, micro SD, by the way. And a USB connector. And at the rear, you've got two connectors. Yeah, probably the motors. Only two? Only two? Only two? Huh. Okay. The printer bed had a connector for this, and the upright also has a connector for this. An on-off switch and a power in. And some braided, nicely braided cables with all kinds of connectors. And the connectors are all labeled. I'm not sure if you'll be able to pick that up. Maybe like this. Yeah, all the connectors have nice labeling on them, which should make assembly a breeze. The next video in this series will be about the setup, by the way. I'm trying to keep all these videos easy to consume, so not too long. Okay, yeah, this. The nice thing about this is that it's pretty safe. This contains the power supply for your entire printer, and there's nothing exposed. No wires, no circuitry, maybe for schools and such, small children, safe. That's nice. What I don't like about this setup is that it's not integrated into the printer itself. It makes it look like an afterthought, this packaging. Maybe it's more convenient for you that you can position this unit somewhere else. Could be, I don't know. I'm sure you'll be able to figure it out, that out for yourself. But it does look very substantial. Cooling vents. It has a fan at the back to pull some air through it. Cooling vent at the bottom with another cooling fan. Cool stuff. Yes, this looks proper. Very nice. Okay, and as you can see, there is one more thing in the box, which is the vertical column, so the riser. And you know what? I'll take that out of the box and then get rid of this box here. Hold on. Okay, here is that last part of our printer, the upright vertical part of our printer. By the way, this printer comes with these, blue rubbery plastic things. But it also comes in yellow, and from what I understand, it's basically a luck of the draw. And you can remove them, by the way. You don't need them. The printer doesn't need these things to operate. Okay, so this will stand upright on the base, and it will be held in place with a couple of brackets and a bunch of screws. Now over here you see the print nozzle, which can obviously move from side to side. This entire bar here can move up and down. That's a little hard to do actually, as you can see, it can move up and down. And the print bed itself can move frontwards and backwards. And that is, what you need, of course, to be able to print in three dimensions. Cool. You know what? Things look good so far. I haven't connected anything up. But so far, the initial inspection, for instance, I've inspected things like slop. And a minute ago, we took a ruler to that bed. I've done it again with the plastic off. It looks really good. The glass plate looks straight as an arrow. Obviously, I am happy about that. Bing? What was that? Okay, once again, I don't want to drag these videos out too long. I want reasonably short videos for this series. This was my unboxing and initial inspection. Nothing seems to be missing. Things look good. In the next video in this series, we'll set this printer up. So we'll take you from this state, unassembled state, to assembled and actually printing. So in the next video, at the end of the video, we'll have an actual print. If all ends well, we'll see. Should be coming up pretty soon. I'll get that video rolling right after this one. So, what can I tell you? If you have questions, of course, hit me up a comment down below. I'll be happy to answer you. Suggestions? Like I said, I'm a novice in this field. So if you have suggestions, tips, tricks, very welcome. Thank you in advance. And catch you on the next video. High five.